Welcome to another episode of the explanatory video series.
What are mutual multilateral recognition arrangements? IAF and ILAC multilateral or mutual recognition arrangements, or MLA-MRAs, are agreements signed by more than two parties to recognize the equivalence of one another's conformity assessment results. The ILAC-MRA and IAF-MLA are established between signatory accreditation bodies to ensure a harmonized implementation of accreditation services and hence a mutual acceptance of one another's accreditations. These arrangements provide assurance that bodies from different economies operate to the same international standard, reducing technical trade barriers by promoting international confidence and acceptance of conformity assessment results. So, what do we mean by conformity assessment? Conformity assessment is the demonstration that a product, service, system, or person meets specified requirements. This can include certification, testing, calibration, inspection, validation and verification, and other activities performed by conformity assessment bodies. The results of these conformity assessment activities are delivered in the form of reports, certificates, and statements. Take the example of product conformity. A toy manufacturer wants to produce and export a product that is enjoyed all over the world without having to set up multiple factories in each country. Proving the conformity of its toys to the target market requirements may include a number of conformity assessment activities. For instance, product certification may be required to ensure the product meets specified requirements, often including regulatory standards. Testing may be required as proof that the product meets certain safety and quality standards. This may include looking at the composition of the product, how the product behaves in certain conditions, such as impact testing, and more. The product storage and shipments may also be required to undergo an inspection or multiple inspections at different stages of the manufacturing process to ensure that there are no quality defects before reaching the consumer. An audit of the production process may be required with a sampling of products from the factory. Lastly, certain product certification schemes may require a management system audit to ensure that the business is complying with its own quality management system framework. Once the product conformity is confirmed, a certificate of conformity or a report is provided to the manufacturer. To prove its competence, the conformity assessment body is assessed at the national level by an accreditation body, which provides an accreditation certificate to the conformity assessment body. A signatory accreditation body to the IAF, MLA, or ILAC-MRA has committed to maintaining its accreditation to the relevant international standards, as well as the requirements set by IAF and ILAC for the consistent application of those standards. Regional cooperation bodies operating a regional MRA, MLA coordinate peer evaluations and in turn also abide by ILAC and IAF procedures and requirements. The ILAC-MRA covers scopes relating to testing, calibration, and medical laboratories, inspection, proficiency testing, and reference materials, while the IAF-MLA covers management systems, product and persons certification, and validation and verification activities. Under the umbrella of the ILAC and IAF arrangements, a report, certificate, or statement delivered in one economy by an accredited conformity assessment body is trusted as equivalent in the other economies. So, when our toy arrives at its target market, the accredited conformity assessment results proving its conformity would prevent the duplication of tests and inspections and give trust to local authorities that the product fulfills the local market's requirements for safety, quality, and consumer expectations. By establishing this process of equivalence and competence of accredited conformity assessment services, the IAF-MLA and ILAC-MRA fulfill both the objectives of facilitating trade and delivering confidence in the supply chains. But how does an accreditation body become a signatory of these arrangements? And what is the difference between ILAC-IAF arrangements and the mutual recognition agreements between economies? These are the subjects of our next explainer videos on the mutual recognition process and the difference between accreditation MRAs and MRAs between economies. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get notified of our latest explainer videos.